maybe you see someone collecting garbage and you might not think about it as garbage, or maybe you see it as someone who is hoarding because that's what they do. These people are judged as dirty and lazy and dumb, or some people call them uneducated, but no one really knows why they end up on the streets or why they do the things they do. Mental disorders are a large reason for such a high impact in homeless populations in the U.S. According to the National Coalition of Homelessness in a 2009 article, many of these lost individuals suffer from mental disorders, which sometimes is the number one reason as to why they cannot sustain a normal life. According to the Volunteers of America website, serious mental disorders include bipolar disorder, depression, and addiction. The people who become homeless are usually low income before they become homeless, which is the number one reason as to why they become homeless. And because they are low income, they usually cannot afford the mental health care that they need to sustain a normal life. So what these people do is they will normally self-medicate with street drugs. And through self-medication, with the use of these street drugs, it can lead them to a long road of drug addiction and drug abuse. 46.2 million Americans live in poverty a year. Of them, 670,000 of them are homeless. Next, I will get into how serious mental disorders get, how they lead into homelessness. Well, like I said before, many of them cannot afford the treatment that they need. They tend to self-medicate. And these serious mental disorders can make someone feel isolated, and that can cause tension between the families that they have that keep them financially stable. So who does homelessness affect? Well, according to the National Center for Family Homelessness, 1.5 million children a year are homeless. It is also known that these children have a higher chance of having emotional and behavioral problems in their future. Also, through the Framework Charity, it has been reported that there are higher rates of homelessness in minorities. And this could be because in minorities, there is a social stigma of mental illness. Because they are living on the streets, they obviously cannot afford medical care. Because of this, they lack the physical health that they need to even be able to get a job in the future. According to the National Alliance to End Homelessness, they have a higher risk of catching HIV. And it was reported that 3.5 million people had HIV in 2006, and 3.4% of them were homeless. That's equivalent to 1,190,000 people who were not only HIV positive, but were also homeless. There was a study based in a New York City shelter that said that people who first went into the shelter had a higher increased chance of having diabetes, and they also had higher blood pressure. And after the 18-month study was over, it was said that the people who were able to find housing and employment, their health had increased, and they were able to have a better chance of living. But for the people who weren't able to find housing outside of the shelter, their chances of dying were higher. So you may say, what has been done to help these people? Well, over the years, many things have been done to get homeless people off the streets. In an article by the National Coalition in 2009, it was reported that Congress had passed a $301 million budget to end homelessness called the American Recovery and Reinvestment Act. But, however, even if homeless individuals were to get housing, it's still most likely that they would end up back on the streets because they are not getting the mental care that they need. So as you can see, it's easy to judge these people and write them off as just being crazy or being drunk, but sometimes you can see that there is probably more to the story.